I am now going to show you how to work with halftones or like screen print photograph type images. Again, this is just a bunch of stuff that I've kind of compiled from different forums, and I took a webinar and different things that I've read and such. So first things first, you're going to either design your image or find an image that you want to screen print on. I did use Photoshop. You will need Photoshop for the next couple steps. They have some other programs out there, like for screen printers, to split the colors up. They're kind of expensive, and if you're like me and it's just a hobby right now, it's really not in the budget. So I do have Photoshop, and you can do it in Photoshop. I'll show you how to split it. It's extremely easy to split it into CYMK mode. And what that stands for is, and forgive me if I say this wrong, cyan, which is the blue, yellow, magenta, and key, which is black. So it splits your image into those four categories. On Photoshop, the only downfall is that it's not very bright. So it really just depends on the inks that you used for the final turnout of the image. So don't get discouraged if you switch it into that mode and you look at it and you're like, oh, this isn't as pretty as it was. Because in my case, that's exactly what happened. But because of the inks that I'm using for the brightness of my image, it turned out great. So in the last video that I did, and we were screen printing like spot images, like I used vellum because it was much cheaper, like so, and I pieced the pieces together to make my image whiter. So like I would put this on the same shirt. I tried to piece images together. I tried to print vellum first, and you cannot do half tones on vellum. Well, at least I wasn't able to make it work, because when I printed my, when you print them, let me show you, let's see if I can get it close. I don't know if you can really see that, but hopefully against the window light you can. There's actually a bunch of little tiny dots. And when you print that on the vellum, the dots didn't want to hold, they wanted to spread. And that just wasn't going to work. So then I went to Hobby Lobby, or actually I think I got them from Joann's. But I got the Udo sheets. Now they do, my next purchase will be from silkscreensupplies.com. He's got a set of 8.5 by 14. We call them transfer sheets for Udo, but in the silkscreen industry, they call them film. And basically, it's different than regular transfer sheets, because like the Udo ones, for example, it's got like a sticky on one side of the transfer sheet because it holds onto that ink and keeps it from spreading. So, and it also keeps it dark. So I know printing on regular transfer sheets, that black almost just, it's kind of clear. So when you print on these, you won't have to like double up or anything, because the black ink really holds well. So I went and got 8.5 by, they come in packs of 5, 8.5 by 11. Just normal paper size. And I printed the first part of the image, I printed landscape, and I printed the first part of the image at the top and the second, and I tried to piece it together. Didn't work. When I burned the screens like that, even though these are clear, anywhere I pieced it together left lines in my screen, so ink would just pour through. So I'd have lines right in the middle of my image. I'm like, well, that's not gonna work. So I ended up having to go back, and I had to get the 11 by 14 sheets that Udo has. Again, they only come in packs of 5, and I mean, it was like, I think $15 for 5 sheets. So it's kind of expensive, $3 a sheet. But I didn't want to go out and spend a lot of money on, because you have to buy them in packs of 100 from silkscreensupplies.com. And they're about $50, $60. And I didn't want to go invest in a big pack if I wasn't going to be able to do this. So I really wanted to just test it out first. And it does work. I really like it. So I also don't have a printer that prints on 11.5. So I actually had to trim off a few inches on each sheet to be able to print on them with my printer. Okay. So I'll show you how to do it, how to split the image in Photoshop, and then what you're going to do is print out a sheet for each color, one for black, yellow, magenta, and cyan. And you also, as you print them, you need some way to mark them, because once you print them, it'll be really difficult to tell. I mean, you'll look at it and you'll be like, I don't think this is going to work. There's no way this is going to work and do all those different colors. But what I did is I just put a little piece of tape down at the bottom and I marked it with a letter to help me remember which sheet was what. And you're going to burn your screens like normal. Let me grab the screen. With my exposure, I don't know if this is because I changed emulsions, because I was done using my green emulsion and I mixed up my pink emulsion that I got from silkscreensupplies.com, and I actually love this stuff so much better. It's actually, you can put it on thinner, and when you're putting the screens on top of each other or on the shirt, you can see through it so much better, so make sure everything's lined up. So I really would recommend this emulsion, and it's actually cheaper than the Speedball stuff that I got from Hobby Lobby. So it comes in a pint, and I think I only got like 8 ounces or so from Hobby Lobby. And Hobby Lobby's is $30. Yes, I used a 40% off coupon, so I did get it for $17. But this is also, for a pint, only $17, and you get more of it, and it's better. So you're gonna, for my exposure times, I had to play with it, because with your halftone dots, I just wasn't sure how long should I leave it, you know, the same amount of time, which is the 8 minutes for transfer sheets when you don't have vellum. So I actually did little by little. I ruined a couple of sheets, but in the end, my time that was good was about 6 minutes to 6 minutes and 30 seconds. So that's what I would recommend, but you can play with yours and make sure that is the time that you have to work with, because you don't want to burn all your screens and then go to wash them off and have more wash off than you want. So let me find it. A different color one. I actually ran out of silk screening tape as well. Put that on my list to order next time. But I use masking tape and it works just as good. The only thing, again, is that you can't wash it and it comes off during the washing process. But I just wanted to see if you guys could, with the light, see how the little dots ended up showing up. I was actually really impressed, because I'm like, I just don't see how this is going to work. But my first test run, I burned all 4 screens. You have to have 4 screens for this. If you don't, it won't work. Reason being is, in the last video, when we printed color on color, we had to flash dry it in between with my hair dryer to get that tacky feel. For this process, you do not want to do that. You actually just want to print wet on wet. The colors blend, just like they would if you printed an image on your inkjet printer at home. Your printer prints wet on wet, and then the colors blend to give it the different colors. The only thing that would change is if I'm doing it on white shirts, but if you're going to do it on a dark shirt, any other color shirt, you can put down a white base first. And I thought about this and I know it'll work. So what you would do is you print off your fifth sheet with your white base, which is gonna look more like the images that we did last time, solid, and doesn't have the variation dots. And you're going to burn that screen first. Now, when you burn that screen, leave the image taped to your screen so it's in the exact same spot. Put your white base down on all four or however many t-shirts you're doing, and then take the emulsion off that screen and you can reuse that one. So that way you don't have to have five screens, you can do it with four. And reuse that screen for the rest of them. And that's why you leave that image taped down, because it's in the exact same spot as you burned it. So then you can burn the rest of the layers that go on top of it on the four screens. Now, I don't have to do that since I'm using white shirts. Now, the order process of them, this was my first print. It's just not very bright. This was my first print. And I was very happy with the detail, especially since it's being my first time ever doing it. But my only issue was that it kind of came out really blue, and I wasn't using, they have CMYK screen printing inks that are made for this, that are in those specific colors. I didn't have those, I didn't want to invest in those if this wasn't going to work. So I had the bright inks that I got from one of the last shirts from Udo. This is the peacock, kind of looks like cyan. This is the fuchsia, kind of looks like magenta, and I just use regular yellow that I got in my starter kit from with my Speedball inks. And I used the black ink that came with my Udo machine. I'm sure I could probably use the Speedball black ink and it'd be about the same, but you kind of want to make sure they're a little watery. So for my first print, I wasn't happy with the blue. I like the shade actually, but it just, the blue overpowered the entire image and it kind of just made it look dark. So after reading on a bunch of different forums, and for this one, my color order was as suggested as the professionals do it, yellow, magenta, cyan, and black. And after reading, it says that you don't necessarily have to do it, that usually they do it from light to dark, but depending on your image, that just might not be right. So if you have a color that overpowers, you may have to play with what order that you do them in. So the other thing that I thought was just maybe this is a little darker than cyan. So I took my little squeeze bottle, I mixed a little bit of white with my peacock and a little bit of water because I wanted to make it a little runnier. But you really have to be careful when, I'm using water-based inks, so that's why I can add water to them. But you have to be careful not to add too much. You add too much and you've just ruined it. So that's also another reason why you want to mix your thing in a separate little bottle. Don't mix it, because you go mixing it with the original and you put too much water in and you've ruined your entire bottle of ink. And if anybody knows about Udo inks, they are so not cheap. It's like $20-something for these set of three inks, and there's 3 ounces of ink in each one. That's not much when it comes to screen printing. For a hobbyist, yeah, but like making a shirt for every day down in Disney, that's not a lot of ink to do. In my case, I'm only doing 4 shirts, so that works for me, but I know a lot of you guys out there are doing 8 shirts, 12 shirts, 15 shirts, when you do trips to Disney, and that's not a lot of ink for that. Okay, so after reading online, I mixed up my separate. I actually did one with the lighter magenta, didn't like the lighter magenta, so I went back to using the full color magenta. That's another reason you don't want to mix it up in the original, because I wasn't happy. Now, I'm still going to keep that ink, because I'll probably find a project for it later, but I only ended up using the lighter cyan and the original magenta. So I tried mixing up the order. This is where you can tell that I used the lighter magenta on this one. And I tried mixing up the order, and I did cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. Didn't like this one as much. I mean, it's better than the last one as far as brightness. But this one I thought had too much yellow, and like the green didn't look green enough. And after reading some more, a lot of people have that issue when you put yellow on top of cyan and not cyan on top of yellow. That the green, it's more of a lemon green versus a grass green. So depending on your image, that you still have to play with it. So I did it a third time on the back of this one on a test shirt. And I ended up loving this order. This is, I went back to the original magenta or fuchsia. I still use the lighter blue. And the order that I did for this one was yellow, cyan, magenta, and black. And I think it turned out beautiful. So you may have to play with your order is basically the point I'm trying to make. So that is the order that I'm going to do. All I did was switch around the cyan and the magenta. Okay. So I'm gonna move the camera over here so you can guys can see. I'm getting ready to do my final print for my four shirts. And you guys can kind of watch the image come to life right before your eyes. It's pretty awesome. But as you guys do it for the first time, you'll probably be like me and look at those dots and just be like, I don't see how this is gonna make my image. But it's a great way to do full color images only using four screens, which I think is absolutely amazing. And it's nowhere near as hard as I thought it was gonna be, so.
By the sun each morning, put my feet on a hardwood floor. I get to hear my children laughing down the hall through the bedroom door. Sometimes I sit on my front porch swing, just soaking up the day. I think to myself, this world is a beautiful place. I have been blessed, and I feel like I found my way. I thank God for all I've been given at the end of every day. I have been blessed with so much more. Yeah.
hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it, want to change the world, there's nothing to it. No life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it, want to change the world, there's nothing to it.